This review was prepared by Davit Marikyan and Savas Papagiannidis and published by TheoryHub. TheoryHub covers a wide range of theories and acts as a starting point for theory exploration in different research and teaching and learning contexts. This is a review of the technology acceptance model. The technology acceptance model explains the acceptance of information systems by individuals. Technology acceptance model postulates that the acceptance of technology is predicted by the user's behavioral intention, which is in turn determined by the perception of technology usefulness in performing the task and perceived ease of its use. The research on the adoption of technology became of primary importance in the 1980s, which coincided with the growth of the use of personal computers. However, a major stumbling stone at the development of the research on the adoption of personal computing was the lack of empirical insight into users' responses to the information system performance. There was a need to develop reliable measures to investigate attitudinal factors mediating the relationship between information system characteristics and system use. As a response to that, Davis developed technology acceptance model. The primary objective of technology acceptance model was to shed light on the processes underpinning the acceptance of technology, in order to predict the behavior of and provide a theoretical explanation for the successful implementation of technology. The practical objective of technology acceptance model was to inform practitioners about measures that they might take prior to the implementation of systems. Davis embarked on the development of the model of technology acceptance by framing the processes mediating the relationship between information systems characteristics and actual system use. The model was based on the theory of reasoned action, which provided a psychological perspective on human behavior and was missing in the information systems literature at that time. The second step was to identify and define variables and validate measures that would highly correlate with system use. Based on prior empirical literature on human behavior and the management of information systems, multi-item scales for perceived ease of use and perceived usefulness were developed, pre-tested, and validated in several studies. It was hypothesized that the two constructs were fundamental determinants of user acceptance, due to evidence in previous research. Perceived usefulness was operationalized based on evidence confirming the effect of system performance expectancy on system usage. Perceived ease of use was defined as the degree to which a person believes that using a particular system is free of effort. The validity and reliability of the constructs were assessed by testing the contingency of the self-reported usage of is on the two proposed factors in the organizational context. The developed scales showed excellent psychometric properties. The model was further validated by confirming significant relationships between perceived usefulness, perceived ease of use, intention, and use behavior. According to technology acceptance model, technology acceptance is a three-stage process whereby external factors trigger cognitive responses, which in turn form an effective response, influencing use behavior. Technology acceptance model represents the behavior as the outcome predicted by perceived ease of use, perceived usefulness, and behavioral intention. Perceived ease of use and perceived usefulness capture the expectations of positive behavioral outcomes and the belief that behavior will not be labor-consuming. According to a follow-up study, behavioral intention can be substituted by the attitude toward behavior, which is an effective evaluation of the potential consequences of the behavior. The higher the effective response, the higher is the likelihood that the behavior will take place. The effect of perceived usefulness on actual use can be direct, which underscores the importance of the variable in predicting behavior. Although perceived ease of use does not affect use behavior directly, it underpins the effect of perceived usefulness. The model implies that if an application is expected to be easy to use, the more likely it is that it will be considered useful for the user and the more likely it is that this will stimulate the acceptance of the technology. The development of the model and measures for technology acceptance have made significant theoretical contributions and have had a great practical value. The application of the model for testing information systems usability has made it possible to evaluate the motivation of users to adopt a range of technologies. The development of constructs which had a strong and significant correlation with use behavior made it possible to understand the cognitive and affective factors mediating the effect of system characteristics on technology acceptance. Given the established relationship between technology acceptance in organizations and firms' productivity, the exploration of technology acceptance remained at the center of the research agenda after the development of the original technology acceptance model. Although the wide application of technology acceptance model confirmed the robustness of the theory, the authors of the model aimed to increase its predictive power further. The rationale for extending the model was the limited understanding of the conditions underpinning users' perception of technology utilization. Perceived usefulness was confirmed to be the strongest predictor of intention to use. However, the literature lacked evidence about the factors that underlie the perception of technology usefulness. Investigation of the antecedents of usefulness perception was required to understand acceptance, as well as to provide guidelines on the development of systems beyond suggesting that users' perception of usefulness and ease of use predict intention. The investigation of key antecedents of perceived usefulness aimed to provide a comprehensive framework for explaining and predicting the acceptance of technology in organizational settings. The proposed extension, named Technology Acceptance Model 2, consisted of 5 additional exogenous variables and 2 moderators. The new constructs and moderators incorporated in Technology Acceptance Model 2 were subjective norm, image, job relevance, output quality, result demonstrability, experience and voluntariness. Empirical examination of the newly proposed model demonstrated that Technology Acceptance Model 2 can account for 60% of the variance in perceived usefulness and between 37% and 52% of the variance in usage intention. The theory has contributed to the literature on the factors underpinning the perception of technology. The original technology acceptance model, its extension and evidence from other studies had provided rich explanations about key determinants of use intention. Still, there had been limited research on interventions which could be used to increase the technology adoption rate. Given that technology acceptance model was criticized for providing few actionable guidelines to practitioners, Venkatesh and Bala in 2008 developed the third version of technology acceptance model. Venkatesh and Bala combined the antecedents of perceived usefulness and perceived ease of use in a single model and investigated the relationship between antecedents and perception variables to exclude crossover effects. Such an approach was to provide a nomological network explaining the adoption of technology in a comprehensive way. The aim of theorizing distinctive effects of variables on perceived usefulness and perceived ease of use was to add clarity to the existing literature. Technology Acceptance Model 3 postulates that actual behavior is predicted by behavioral intention, and behavioral intention is underpinned by perceived usefulness and perceived ease of use, each of which has a set of antecedents. The determinants of perceived usefulness include subjective norm, image, job relevance, output quality, and result demonstrability. New to this model were the direct predictors of perceived ease of use, which include computer self-efficacy, perception of external control, computer anxiety, computer playfulness, perceived enjoyment and objective usability. The rationale for incorporating these antecedents derived from evidence on human decision-making. The antecedents of perceived ease of use represent 2 sets of anchoring and adjustment factors. The anchoring factors are computer anxiety, computer self-efficacy, perception of external control and computer playfulness. Computer anxiety, computer self-efficacy, perception of external control differentiate users based on the degree of their apprehension related to the use of technology, the belief in their personal capability of performing a task using the technology and the belief that they have access to the organizational and technical resources that can support the use of the system. Computer playfulness is defined as the degree of cognitive spontaneity in microcomputer interaction. It represents the intrinsic motivation associated with the use of computers. Adjustment factors include perceived enjoyment and objective usability. They measure the degree to which information systems are perceived to be enjoyable and the level of effort the systems require to complete specific tasks. While anchoring factors drive the initial judgment of perceived ease of use, adjustment factors come into play after individuals gain direct experience with information systems. Technology acceptance model 3 proved to be robust in explaining the use of information systems or use intention. The model accounted for between 40% and 53% of the variance in behavioral intention and around 36% of the variance in use. However, the main strength of the extension is the development of the behavioral model of antecedents of both the perception factors. This provides an exhaustive set of conditions and scenarios under which the acceptance of technology is most likely to occur. By delineating the relationships between antecedents, perceived ease of use, and perceived usefulness, Technology Acceptance Model 3 offers a comprehensive list of interventions that have direct implications for decision-making regarding IT implementation and management. Thank you for listening. To download the full review of the Technology Acceptance Model or to read other theory reviews, visit open.ncl.ac.uk.